Shalom. It's almost Shabbat, and I wanted to speak about this Shabbat. This Shabbat is Parashat Korach, and it's the Shabbat Mevarchim of the month of Tammuz. Our Jewish calendar is kind of a symbol to the Jewish world of time, and it's different from our regular calendar that we use daily basis. Also, it's kind of a Jewish status symbol of how firm are you? Do you know what is the Jewish date today? But if we're looking for a minute for the origin of this calendar, it's actually a Babylonian calendar, a Babylonian calendar. It came from the ancient culture of Babylon. Although they are working also with a calendar that works through months and through and not through the sun, and because of that, the people, Olei Bavel, the people that came back to Israel between the first and the second temple, used it and actually kind of convert this calendar and made him Jewish. And when we look carefully and learn about this calendar, so actually we learn that each of the names in this, in the Jewish Babylonian calendar, is, and it's from Akkadit, the language that they spoke then, and it speaks also about agricultural times, like every month is a symbol for what happens agricultural, but also there are months that are not just about agricultural, as the month of Tammuz, because the month of Tammuz, the name Tammuz, is actually an ancient god, the god of fertility and flourishment, that according to the belief in the ancient times, in this time of year, he was going down to Netherworld, El Sheol in Hebrew, at the beginning of every summer, when summer is starting to be hot, he's going to Netherworld, and he's coming back after half a year, after the rains are coming back. And this god, actually, we have his name, its name in the Bible, in the book of Yechezkel. When Yechezkel is going to see what's happening at the temple, there is idolatry there, and then he see v'hine sham hanashim yoshvot mevakot et ha-tamuz, and there sat the woman bewailing Tammuz, because the tradition was that in this time of year, when Tammuz is going to Lashol, to the netherworld, so the woman need to sit and cry the fact that he left. I think it's really interesting that a calendar in Akkadit, in like of the ancient Babylon tradition, became kind of mainstream Jewish, even as I said, a symbol for status of frum, how frum are you? Because this is the calendar, and it's not just the calendar that we use, that's the calendar that we are setting our month and our holidays according to this Babylonian calendar. And I think that it's interesting to see this, specifically the month of Tammuz, that we see that it's about a god of fertility, a god in that in our words in Hebrew we might call him El Hayetzel. And it just took me to a very interesting and famous Agadita story in the Talmud. It's also in Masechet Sotah, in Masechet Sanhedrin, and it speaks about the sages that want to control the Yetzer, that want to control the Yetzer. And it starts like that the sages says, they are speaking about the evil inclination. They are starting from the evil inclination for idol worship, that they want to destroy it. And they say, and they ask for God, they tell him, you just made this inclination that we will be able to control him. But if we can't control him, because we see what happened, and we can't control him, so we want to kill him. We want to kill him, although we know that we won't receive the reward that we were supposed to when we overcome it. And then God gave them a sign. I'm sorry, I'm just doing it so short, this part of the story. And God gave them a sign, and they are able to destroy this evil inclination for idol worship. And then the second part of this story, they say, since it worked, we asked God and he helped us, maybe let us pray for mercy concerning the evil inclination for sin concerning sexual matters. Yetzer hara, as we usually, when we speak about yetzer hara, that's the yetzer hara that we speak. And they prayed for mercy, and also they understood from God that that God will help them. Excuse me, that God will help them, and he delivered him into their hands. And then it's interesting because this evil inclination tells them, you know, if you'll kill me as you did to the last one, the world will die. So they are not sure, so they are put in prison for 3 days. And then, Chavshuhu Tlata Yome, they are looking for an egg in all of the world, and they don't find even one egg. Because as we know, this evil inclination, the yetzer, the urge for sexual matters, is also the one that makes fertility, makes eggs, for this example. And then they didn't know what to do, because they said, God is black and white, and we ask to kill this urge. Now what we are going to do? Because half and half won't work. And then they are thinking what to do, and they decided to gouge out his eyes. What it means, they like kind of punch his eyes or affect this inclination eye. And how it helped? It helped only for Giloy Arayot. And this was effective in limiting it to the extent that the person is no longer aroused to commit incest with his close relatives. That's the story. Now, I think it's an unbelievable story, and it's really interesting, and we can speak hours about it. But what I wanted to speak from all this story, this is a story of a struggle of the sages in the evil inclination, Yetzer Hara, the one that leads us to idolatry, the one that apparently, according to this story, you can just vanish. It's a question that maybe we'll speak about in a different time, but it's also their struggle to cancel the evil inclination that concerns sexual matters. And then they understand that they can't really vanish it. And what is the conclusion in this story? That this inclination is important. Hayetzer is important. He's a lead organ that helps humanity. But the question is how we cope with the parts that make us bad, that leads us to bad. According to this story, we have a lot what to work with, coping with it, but it's impossible to continue the world without it. So now that we don't have this permission from God to vanish it, the coping is with humankind. And we need to somehow do this challenge and to create a world that works with harmony and struggle in this important urge when we don't have a balance of it. And I want to connect between this and our calendar, because I think that in our world, we have a lot of coping with a lot of struggles with things that are coming out of our tradition and the things that are not considering good and how we act with them. And according to this story in the Talmud, the understanding or the hope, and that, oh, in the ideal world, we won't have any cope. We won't need to cope with anything. It's just not realistic. because we need this desire, we need this yetzer, but we need to know how to control it. And we need to work in the world in the sense, as Rabbi Meir would say, the Tanaic sage, and he says it in Chagigah, he's saying it in, he gave a reference from a pomegranate. A pomegranate ate its contact while throwing away its pill. We need to know how to work with the good stuff and to quit in the moment that it become evil, became bad. And I think that the example of the Jewish calendar / Babylonian calendar is really interesting in this sense. We don't want to kill the urge. We want to find the balance between it. And the story, and the essence of this story, I think, is about balancing, is about, are we able to get some culture, even values that are outside from our world, and to use it, to just use what is good in it, and to throw the things that might hurt our values. And it's not a postmodern saying. That's what the Talmud tells us. And all of our Jewish life works like that. Like, if we will take the Rambam, Maimonides, he entered our Jewish world ideas of Aristotle, Aristo in Hebrew, that till this time, till the time of Maimonides, you are heresy if you used Aristotle. And it wasn't a character that you can learn from it. But when the Rambam, Maimonides, put it inside his guide to the perplexed, it becomes something that we can speak with. And also this Babylonian calendar, that Olei Bavel, the people that came to Israel from Babylon, took this calendar and they transfer it to be ours. Our calendar, our holidays, our fast days, everything is according to this calendar. Tochno achal klipato zarak. Ate its contact while throwing away the pill. Tammuz for us, it's not a month of crying about the death of the god of fertility, Tammuz. It's a month of summer with citrus fruit and big heat. Well, if you live in Israel, so it's big heat. And the question is, can we use this learning? Are we able to enter to our world with different values, even if they're not like traditionally original Jewish values, to take the good from them, but also to be very careful to maintain that they won't take over about our values. They will just help us. And that's a demand for a complex world. But it's an important demand. We are not closing our eyes, whatever is happening in the world. We use it in the tools that God made in our world. Good luck and Shabbat Shalom.